So I say I'm walking up to the top of the beat. This is on the River Doon. And tensions is the fish, just some wet flies, and work my way through all the nice wee runs and see how things go. Obviously if there's fish rising, it'd be silly not to get the dry fly on, because that's what I love to fish, is the dry fly. So it's quite windy today, there's a bit of a breeze, but we are sheltered. It just depends on the direction, what way it comes, kind of in between the bushes or the trees. But other than that, it's not going to bother me, I'll just work away. This is getting out, whether we catch fish or not, it's the main thing, is getting out and keeping fit, enjoying the fishing. So just, you see, this is the path, it's got a bit of man-made influence, the beat gets well maintained and looked after. Obviously the trees don't get touched as much on the river, that's natural, but the path is just to help us old men get up and down the water, as they say. So anyway, we're motoring up the top. It's not a far distance, but take me a good 10 minutes anyway or so to get up there and get the rod on or set up. So here we go. This is the middle of the beat, so you see, that's a lovely run. You'll get fish right up. Now the Doon doesn't have, like in the River Ayr, grayling. Mainly brown trout. Then migratory fish like the sea trout and salmon. Not so many sea trout around nowadays, but not so many salmon either. But anyway, it is renowned more for its salmon fishing than its trout. Now we're near the top of the beat. So we are. Just show you, well, the river's there. That goes up. And now we're up to the end here. It goes a wee bit further up, but I'm going to start at the top of the field here. Now, I'm going to stick to the edge of the field. Otherwise, I know it's just grass, it's basically going to be silage. I don't want to flatten it, so stick to the where the weeds are. You can see there's plenty of them on this side. So if you see a farmer's field, it's got some sort of is growing, whatever it be, grass or be some kind of cereal or some sort. Don't walk through the middle of it. And don't think highly of you. So just maybe the shorter route, but this route's so much the same anyway. It's amazing how quick this has grown since the last time I was here. It was hardly at my ankles. Now it's more like at my knees. So anyway, we'll soon get there. Here we're at the top of, well, not so much top of the beat, but nearly at the top of the beat. And this is where I'm going to start. So we've got a nice wee run. It's a great pool, this, for the salmon. But it's, they say I'm going to be fishing for trout. It's a wee bit early in the season for, I mean, there will be a fish there. It's just, I'm going to concentrate on the trout. And go from there. I'm going to set up. You may hear me pecking, as they say, but just crossed that field there and the sun's really warm. It's warmer than I thought. So anyway, we do, we line up the dots, secure the rod. Always work for the tip down. Taking the rod away from you, less chance of you breaking your rod. It's great if they put, every rod manufacturer should put a simple wee thing just to line up the rod. Two wee dots. This is my 8 foot 10 inch rod. Which one's a, you can see there, it's a Piriwee. It's a 8 foot 10 5 weight. This is the X series. Got this from Jeff Piriwee. Oh, it must be around about 2013. It's a lovely wee rod. And it's ideal for dry fly and wet fly. I like it. Yeah, my first dropper, I'm going to have it about 4 foot from the fly line. Now, I don't know if you can see this okay, but anyway, I just use a top blood knot. You're looking for maybe a dropper around about 6 inches or so. I just basically wind up the line with one end through the back with this one about 5 times. And then I hold that, just form the loop. Wind the opposite way, you must wind the opposite way. Your dropper length. There's a couple of ways of doing this knot. And then with that one was through the back and this one's through the front. So it's so that it, when you pull it tight, it screws, tightens into itself like screwing against one another. Just, I'll show you what I mean by one knot goes one way and one goes the other way. So you just moisten, pull it nice and tight. There's a small end, just trim that away. Oops, check my leader there. So that's my top dropper. It hangs nice and straight, it's really tight. And then round about, as I say, another 4 foot, form another dropper. Now you can put on, a lot of times I just fish two flies. It's easier, less tangles, but I'm going to fish three the day. Again, so pull it through. Just keep going, it doesn't take long. And I don't go much more than about 5 times round. Don't go much less either, so 5 is a good number for some reason. Pull your dropper out, hold both ends together, pull them in. So as they start to come in like that, just moisten it, slowly pull it so it binds. And then the small end, trim away. So there we are. And then I've got the leader length I've got, I should have 5 or so feet to the point. And that's basically us ready to put the flies on. So now I brought these together to show you. Now this is, there's been quite a few flies hatching over the last few weeks. A few caddis, a few olives, obviously need the nymph pattern. So in this cast, it's quite modern, like obviously with the style of flies. So what I've got in the top is a caddis pupa. It's basically due to its, like, if you're equivalent to a swimming caddis pattern, or a drifting caddis that I call it quite a lot. It's got a wee fluorescent highlight rib which shows up really well. I've got this one here, which is like a rat pattern, I call it. Basically, it's just a traditional winged like style nymph pattern. And the point, I've got the pheasant tail style fly. This is the one I was tied recently. It's basically blue and yellow macaw. You don't even see in that light, the way the light hits it. But basically, that's just a natural colour. It's just really well. It's got the yellow blue type colour, but that gives you a nice olive. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm basically casting like I was fishing a dry fly, and I'm just keeping the rod up and I'm watching the tip of my line and allowing the flies to drift best I can under some kind of control. And I try and keep the tip of the line, or the tip of the rod, sorry, and 90 degrees to the fly line, and then just work it out. Now, I don't have a back cast at all. Now, just let it drift. The soft hackle wets and nymphs fishing. You just need to watch for a pause. And there we go. There's just pause for a second, and straight away I've got a brown trout. Gosh, that was quick. So there you go, and that tain the nymph, that tain the, basically, which is equivalent to a pheasant tail. Just a wee brown trout. We'll see what it's like. Spring it towards us. Now, I'm just going to lift him because he's hooked lightly on the southers. Take the hook out very easy because it's barbless. And there we go. That was very quick. And that shows you how quickly these flies, or quickly you can catch. And all that was basically the line slowing up, and I lifted. So cast it upstream, basically that allows the flies to settle. And then I've got a fluorescent tip, I mean it's just, I can see the tip a wee bit, it helps. But you don't need it, it's there as an aid. And then when I start to bring it towards me, I keep the rod 90 degrees. And then you can slowly pull towards you. And there we are, and then we can go back up. And then we can fish the pool. I'm just going to mend it a wee bit. Just too much drag in the middle there. It's no use if you can't control your fly. And as I say, bring your rod. Let it swing round. And watch for that pause. Now I'm going to try a wee bit closer because fish are just going to be at your feet. So again, another way is just to lift the rod point. Just watch the tip of your line. Always drift the point with the line as it comes down. And then you can bring it towards yourself. And there we are. Back out. Again, just do it both ways. So I'm trying to cover as much of the water as I can in different ways to present the fly. So we'll do one upstream, one slightly downstream and across. See what, well, we've got one to the upstream cast. So we have. I said, just bring the rod towards the bank, 90 degrees from the fly line. Now every so often, just check your flies. Make sure everything's fine, yep. Any good fishing with a tangle. Cast downstream. Keep the rod up. See, it's a windy day. There's no little leaf there. There you go. So one each. We've got. That was a. Paid that really hard. There's another brown trout. Oh, expect brown trout here. Oh, it's a bait. Ash, they start taking the middle fly, so that was the wee rat. So anyway, there we go, one up, one each. So it was a really hard day. I should really check my fly, but gosh, there's another one. Must be just some fish there. Oh, that turned the top dropper, this one, this time. Did it settle? That's another lovely wee brown trout. That turned the caddis. There we go.
Let him go.
There you go. See, typical brownies, they do like a fly, it comes onto them like that. But right, I'll do an upstream. So it's 2-1 to the downstream. So there we are. Now we've came further down. We're fishing a pool at the moment, or we're going to be fishing this pool here. It's not the one I've had many fish out. It's a good salmon pool, and it's sheltered. I mean, it's got plenty of tree cover. There's no sun on it, which certainly helps. Unfortunately, this is a lovely pool here, but in our bank, it's just basically trees. It's really hard to get into and fish, so we have to come down here to some steps and see go onto the water. Years ago, I jumped off there like Spider-Man. Was it Spider-Man or somebody like that? Anyway, but ain't no Spider-Man anymore. I jumped down this one. But anyway, still got the same flies on. They're just fishing the wets. Got the wets away. I wish the birds are singing today. I'm just looking upstream there to see. I'll let you see what it looks like. I don't know if you can see it. I've got a lovely runaway up here, but it's the other side is not. I only can fish this side. So anyway, I'm still happy to fish this. But you can come out, you can walk up the centre and fish, but if there was fish rising there, I definitely would be there. So anyway, we'll get into here, we'll fish this pool. We'll start off a wee short cast here. Bring the flies through, and I'm just going to lengthen the cast. Just, there's no back cast here, but anyway. I'm not much of a back cast anyway. Just allow it to drift through, and then bring the rod. The roll. Actually a better back cast than I thought. There you go. It's quite fast there, so just keep the rod side to it. As I say, it's a, if you keep the rod quite high, there's a sun coming on the pool now, but I actually thought it was sheltered through the sun, but anyway, it's not. Just got some cloud there. Just to stop it fishing, right? But anyway. Just a wee cast across and let it fish downstream. Bend upstream. It can be productive this way. Keep the rod reasonably high and watch the tip of the brine. There we go. Gosh. It's a day for the... Although this is a good brownie. one's two and a dropper. It's two and the... I think it's a dropper anyway. Yep. He's doing the wet fly. The... It's a lovely fish. Just lift him up nice and easy. Take the fly out, he's on the scissors. Beautiful brown trout. And away he goes. I'll show you the fly that was on. It doesn't look much, but basically, I'll put a link to this fly, because I've actually got that on YouTube. It's a great pattern. It's just a... It's a kind of rat pattern, because I use rodent, or it's basically, it's called the rodent, because it's actually used a rodent-type dubbing, like a mouse. But you can use anything, really, that's quite close to it, like fox squirrel. Let's give me again, and we let this drop. That fish took when it's side on like this, it basically pulled into the rod, the 90 degree bend, and so it hooked itself really. Well, folks, just having a wee quick cast in this pool just before I head home. So anyway, I'll put some of the footage, I'll put it all on, like, but I'll put some of the footage on for you to see and how the day went. That's a good at the end here, it's just really bright now. It's bright most of the day, but it was really quiet now. Nothing really, nothing coming off. I don't see any odd me. Just wish I would stop talking. Anyway, I just lost one there. That was a nice brownie. So I'll just say fishing this wee run. I always know there's one or two fish lying in this area. And under the trees as well, that's why I'm here, because it's so quiet, it's so bright. But anyway, I'll show the flies, show the fish I caught. I'm always doing a wee bit, hopefully I'll get enough out it, and I hope you enjoy the video. But as I say, I'm just going to fish down to this wee croy, this wee... Oops. I'm fishing below myself. It's not the... You get takes, but you miss quite more. It's just the... Where I am, it's such perfect for casting because of all the trees behind me. But anyway, at least I've hooked a fish, as you saw, and lost it. So... Popping them out. As I say, I've got I've put the flies up so you can see the ones I've been fishing. I haven't changed, I've kept the same cast, same flies. If I'd seen fish rising, I'd have changed, obviously. Or if I wasn't catching anything, anyway. But I've been catching any fish that's been around, I've had pools, I've had lots of things, so... A little branch falling off. So, just fly over there, because I... Anyway, I hope you enjoy the video when I put it up on YouTube. And again, I know you enjoy watching, so I hope you enjoy it, and thanks again.